Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to explain steam formation at constant pressure. Here we are going to discuss temperature versus enthalpy diagram for steam formation at constant pressure. I have assumed over here the pressure is 1 bar. So simply we can say the steam formation at 1 bar pressure. And this is temperature versus enthalpy diagram. So always temperature is on the y-axis and enthalpy is on the x-axis. And you know that temperature is denoted by T, whereas enthalpy is denoted by H. Now if you assume Ti, that means temperature of ice, is at initially minus 10 degrees Celsius. So let's assume the steam formation is from the ice, which is at minus 10 degrees Celsius. So this is actually the temperature of ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius. Now next, let's say it is the point A. Now if you supply some amount of heat, then it will reach up to this point. And let's say it is at 0 degrees Celsius. So if you provide some amount of the heat, then the temperature of the ice will increase from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. That means there is a 10 degree rise in the temperature of ice. And let's say it is a point B. So we can say during the process A to B, sensible heat is added to the ice. Therefore, its temperature will increase up to its melting temperature. So I can say this amount of the heat, that is called as the Hi, that means the heat that is given to the ice. So sometimes this heat is called as the sensible heat of the ice, because if you know that during the sensible heat the temperature will rise only. And so that this portion is called as the solid phase, because of during the process A to B, the phase is still ice. So we can say the solid phase is there. Now if you further supply the heat, then it will reach at this point. Let's say it is C point. So during the process B to C, we can say latent heat is added, so that ice starts to melt. Gradually, ice converts into water, and this is known as the latent heat of ice, or you can say heat of fusion. So we can say this is a melting process of the ice, and this heat that is known as latent heat of ice. So keep in mind that due to the sensible heat, the temperature rises, and due to the latent heat, phase changes. So in this portion, we can say it is actually the mixture of solid and liquid, because of this is the melting point, and gradually it will melt from ice to liquid. So this is a mixture of solid as well as liquid. Now if you further supply heat, then it will reach at this point, and this temperature is known as the saturation temperature of the water. Let's say it is 100 degrees Celsius, because of at 1 bar pressure the saturation temperature of the water is 100 degrees Celsius. So this is the saturation temperature. Let's say it is point D. So we can say during the process C to D, on further heat addition, water temperature will increase up to its saturation temperature. Here you can see. And particularly at this point, we can say the liquid is saturated. And this amount of the heat, that is called as the HF, that means the enthalpy of fluid. So during this process, the temperature will rise. So we can say this amount is called as the sensible heat also. And here the phase is liquid only, because this is the sensible heat, so there will be no any phase change, only temperature rises. Now if you further supply some amount of the heat, then it will reach up to this point, and that is, let's say, E point. So we can say during this process, that means DE process, latent heat is added at constant temperature. Here you can see at constant temperature, boiling of water starts at point D and it continues up to point E. Heat added during this process is known as latent heat of vaporization. So exactly at point E, the steam is completely converted into the gaseous phase, and so that at point E we can say it is dry saturated steam, and the process is known as vaporization. The amount of the heat during this vaporization is called as HFG. That means heat of vaporization, or you can say the amount of the heat required to convert fluid into gaseous phase. That's why it is HFG. So in this space, there is a mixture of liquid and gas. Because of at point D, vaporization starts, and exactly at point E, it is completely converted into gaseous phase. So we can say in this space, there is a mixture of liquid and gas. Now next, if you further supply some amount of the heat, then it will reach up to this point, and that is called as the superheating process. Let's say it is F point. So we can say on further heat addition, steam temperature will increase more than its saturation temperature. Here you can see, because of TS, that is your saturation temperature, and it is now more than saturation temperature, and this steam is known as superheated steam. So beyond the point E, the steam is known as superheated steam. Exactly at point E, the steam is known as dry saturated steam, and during the process D2E, the steam is known as wet steam. Now see, if the temperature of the steam at point F, then it is denoted by T superheated, that means superheated temperature of the steam. And the difference between these two temperature, that means superheated temperature and saturation temperature, is known as degree of superheat. And the amount of the heat that is supplied during the superheating process is known as heat of superheat. And you know that the phase during the process E to F, that is only gas, because of at point E, it is completely dry saturated steam, that means pure gaseous phase. And if you further supply some amount of the heat, then only the temperature will rise, but the phase is constant, and that is the gaseous phase. Now look at this diagram. The amount of HF plus HFG, that is known as HG, that means enthalpy of the gaseous phase. Because of, you know that at point E, it is completely gaseous phase, and if you consider this is as a reference point, so HG, that is the amount of the heat required to convert the water at 0 degree Celsius to the dry saturated steam at 100 degree Celsius, and that is equal to HF plus HFG, and this is called as the enthalpy of the superheated steam, because of here the steam is superheated steam. So with reference to the C point, we can say this is the enthalpy required to convert water from 0 degree Celsius to the superheated steam. This is the HI, that means the sensible heat of ice. And you know that always sensible heat is Cp delta T. So here Cp delta T, that means change in temperature. So here you know that change in temperature is from 0 to 10 degree Celsius. So this is the change in temperature 0 and Ti, whatever it may be the temperature of ice initially. Next, this HF, that is also sensible heat. Here you can see the temperature change, that means sensible heat. And you know that sensible heat, that means Cp delta T. But here Cp, that means there is a liquid phase, so it is Cpw, that means specific heat of water at constant pressure. And delta T, that is the change in temperature. So here you can see 0 degree and saturation temperature. So this is the change in temperature. Now here once again you can see the temperature change, that means it is sensible heat. And so that once again the same formula Cp delta T. But here this is the steam, so it will be Cps, that means specific heat of steam at constant pressure. And this is the change in temperature. And here you can see the change in temperature is T superheated and T saturation. And you have to remember this also, Cpw, that means the specific heat of water at constant pressure, that is 4.2 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. And Cps, that means specific heat of steam at constant pressure, is 2.1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Next, Cpi, here you can see, that means specific heat of ice at constant pressure, that is also 2.1 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So put your valuable feedback in the comment box for motivating me to make more videos. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video.